Hello guys, welcome to How to iOS YouTube channel. This is going to be an exciting video about Palera1n Windows Jailbreak from iOS 15 all the way to iOS 15.7.1. In this detailed step-by-step video, I will show you how to install Palera1n on Windows using the Linux method. I know many of you guys facing an issue about iPhone coming out of the DFU mode while jailbreaking with the Palera1n. I will also show you how you can fix DFU mode problem and the device won't turn on while jailbreaking. I hope I got your attention now. I will be using the Linux as there are important packages and dependencies that can only be done through the Linux or Mac. First, we need to download some things. We need Ubuntu ISO file. This is the Ubuntu official website. Download the latest version. And we also need to download the Rufus tool that we will use to make the Ubuntu iOS file bootable USB. I will also give you the links below in this video's description. Moreover, this is the official Palera1n GitHub page that shows all the Palera1n info. Jailbreaking with the Palera1n is a lengthy process with the help of commands. Therefore, you need to follow it patiently to avoid any errors, because if you miss something, you have to start over again to download Palera1n Windows Jailbreak. Let's first see which iOS versions and devices the Palera1n Jailbreak supports. It supports all the checkmate devices only, running on iOS 15 all the way to iOS 15.7.1. These are the same devices that are supported by the Palera1n Jailbreak. You can also see on your screen. Also, a new jailbreak, Sheena 12, is released now for testing purpose. It supports iOS 15 to iOS 15.1.1 from iPhone 6 to iPhone 13. There is no checkmate device restriction for it. If you want me to make a tutorial on that, tell me in the comments below and also subscribe to the channel for that. I am installing Palera1n using Windows PC through the Linux, because the dependencies and packages that Palera1n needs only come with the Linux and Mac. The Mac tutorial link is below in this video's description. If you are a Mac user, you can follow that. Now before I start the tutorial, this is important to note that there are two modes to install the Palera1n. One is tethered and other one is semi-tethered. For semi-tethered mode, you need to have at least 16 gigs of free internal storage in your device. Then you can install the semi-tethered Palera1n jailbreak on your device. The jailbreak uses around 10 gigs of storage. If you have less storage available, don't use this method. Then you can go with the tethered mode. More on it later in this video, how to install a specific mode. As you have downloaded both the Linux ISO file and Rufus tool, now you need to make the Linux bootable USB. For that, attach an empty USB drive with your Windows PC and open the Rufus tool. See if your USB is shown as connected, then select the Linux file. You can just drag and drop it. You don't need to change any other settings, just click on the start button. The process will take a little while depending on how fast your PC is. And a bootable Linux USB will be ready for Palera1n Windows Jailbreak installation. As you can see, now it's done. Now keep the bootable USB connected to the PC and restart your computer. Once the screen is off, you need to go into the BIOS settings. For different computers and laptop, different key is used to enter. For me, I have to press the escape key after the restart to enter in the BIOS settings. You can try using either the escape key or F12 or F10 key. If none of these work, you can Google for your computer how to enter into the BIOS settings. Once you are on this blue screen, go to the boot option, then go in the boot type option here. You need to either select the USB and hit enter, or move the USB to the top of the list and save. For me, I have to put it on the top and save. Once you save that, the computer will restart again and boot through the attached USB. As the process is going on, let me just show you, I am running on iOS 15.7.1. Also, if you are on A10 or A11 devices, you need to disable the passcode, face ID or touch ID. I am adding cuts and fast forwards in the video. As you can see, the system is loading the Linux operating system. It will take a little time to show you a window with two options and a language bar at the side. Here it is. One is the try Ubuntu and other one is the install Ubuntu option. First, select the preferred language, then click on the try Ubuntu. as we are just using the Linux for Palera1n Jailbreak on Windows PC, not for installing permanently on our PC as a dual boot option. As you click on it, just after a while, it will show you the Linux desktop. If you haven't hit the subscribe button yet, please hit the subscribe button, also the like button. Now I will show you how to download Palera1n Windows Jailbreak. Before that, installing multiple dependencies and packages are a part of Palera1n Windows Jailbreak download, and you must install those. I am showing you all the things you need to perform on your PC. You need to go through it carefully, guys, and it's a command-based process. Now open the Firefox, go to Google. Here, type Palera1n Windows Tech Acrobat and hit enter. Open this link, or if you want to try out the Mac tutorial, type Palera1n Mac Tech Acrobat and open this link. As the Windows page opens, scroll down to the command section. It's a complete guide from A to Z for Palera1n Windows Jailbreak. Here is the command section, guys. Now you need to perform every step with me. Run the commands one by one and hit enter on the terminal. Right click on the Linux desktop and select open the terminal. Then copy and paste this command and hit enter. Now copy the second command, paste in the terminal and hit enter. Do this for all the commands here, but till before the Palera1n cloning command. I am just fast forwarding the video to save the time. If you haven't hit the subscribe button yet, please hit the subscribe button, also the like button. I am adding cuts and fast forwards in the video. Once you have installed all the packages and dependencies needed for the Palera1n Windows Jailbreak, now we will download the Palera1n Jailbreak folder on the Linux. For that, copy and paste this command on the terminal and hit enter. This command will download the Palera1n Jailbreak folder on the Linux desktop. It may take a while, keep wait and let it complete. It will download around 300 to 400 MB of the files. Once it's completed, you will see the Palera1n folder downloaded on the desktop, and on the terminal, the location will be automatically set to the Palera1n. But just in case you have closed the previous terminal, then you have to open the terminal from inside of the Palera1n folder. Once the device is connected, open a new terminal from the Linux desktop. Remember, this time you already have one terminal open from inside of the Palera1n Jailbreak folder. You need to open a new terminal from the desktop to run these two commands I'm just going to show you one by one. Just copy and paste these commands one by one and hit enter and minimize the terminal. Once that is done, now I will run the Palera1n installation command, which is this one. But don't just copy and paste on the terminal as it is. Make necessary changes, like replace the iOS version. For me, it's 15.7.1. If your device's version is different, put your iOS version here. Moreover, I am installing semi-tethered mode. Therefore, I added --semi-tethered at the end of the command. If you want to install the tethered Palera1n for Windows Jailbreak, remove this part from the end. What these semi-tethered and tethered do, I already have explained. You can rewind the video to know about both of these modes. Also, put this command on the terminal that is open from inside of the Palera1n folder. Once the command is set according to your device, now you need to put your device in the DFU mode. Now this is the main part where the user see an issue that their iPhone comes out of the DFU mode while jailbreaking with the Palera1n Jailbreak. For DFU mode, do not use any other method to put your device into the DFU mode like the one you have seen on Palera1n Jailbreak app, where you need to hold on both buttons for 4 seconds and then leave one and keep holding the other. Don't use that method for the DFU mode. Do the one I am using. It may sound strange to you, but many of you already have faced this issue, including me. To enter into the DFU mode, I use this method on my iPhone 7. Press and hold the power and volume down button for 10 seconds. After 10 seconds, leave the power button and keep holding the volume down button for next 8 seconds. Then leave the volume button as well. This time, the device will be in the DFU mode. Just leave the device. You will see it's in the DFU mode once we run the command. And yes, device will not come out of the DFU mode. Give me a thumbs up and a subscribe if your device doesn't come out of the DFU mode as well. Many users are facing this issue. Now wait for the process to progress. Now it's creating the RAM disk. The process is still going on. Be patient. Now it's booting the RAM disk. You can see the Palera1n logo on the device as well. Guys, if you have made this far in the video, do subscribe to my channel to help me reach 2000 subscribers. As the process is still going on, hit the red subscribe button. Now it's creating fake FS. This process will take 10 minutes. I am adding curves and fast forwards in the video. Also pausing the video so the device I am recording the video from doesn't run out of the storage. As you can see, it's stating done. Rebooting your device. Do not disconnect your device yet. The process is not completed yet. The device will enter into the recovery mode now, and then you need to manually put it in the DFU mode. Let me just put the device in the DFU mode using the same method I used earlier. Once it's in the DFU mode, press spacebar or enter on the terminal. The process will go on. As you can see, the terminal is stating the device is in the DFU mode. The process will go on. Now it's stating booting your device. The device will turn on and you can use the tips app to install the Sileo and substrate. Here is the tips app. At this point, the recording device is showing me an error of the low storage. So I will just cut the video here, but I will tell you the steps you need to perform now. Open the tips app, tap on the tools, then tap on the do all button. After that, tap on the install button. It will install bootstrap, substrate and Sileo on your device, which you can use to install the Sileo tweaks for iOS 15. But remember to upgrade all the packages once you open the Sileo for the first time, and after that download the tweaks. If you want me to make a tutorial on Palera1n Jailbreak compatible tweaks, tell me below in the comments. I will make one. This is guys how to download Palera1n Windows Jailbreak iOS 15 using Linux Bootable USB. If you face any issue, let me know in the comments. Thank you for watching.